Okay, so hi everyone. So in this presentation, I will give you some insight about the interaction between mantle plumes, mantle convection, and plate tectonics from the perspective of numerical modeling. And so this work started quite some time ago when I was in Sydney and was finally out last year. So very early in our understanding of Hirth plate tectonics and mantle convection, geoscientists have used the concept of mantle plumes to explain the presence of hotspot tracks at the surface of the Earth, and they were then believed to be fixed. So we have used mantle plumes as absolute reference frames for reconstructing past plate motions, as shown on this animation, where hotspots are in red. But there are multiple paleomagnetic evidences suggesting that mantle plumes are not fixed, such as this study by Tarduno et al. In 2003, showing a southward motion of the Hawaiian hotspot, possibly reaching a speed of 5 centimeters per year between 80 and 60 million years. And a series of geodynamic explanations have been invoked to explain the fixity or the mobility of mantle plumes. So plumes could be either captured and released by ridges, be deflected by mantle wind, interact with slabs, or stay anchored at the edges of dense basal thermochemical piles, which are possibly representing LLSVPs. But while all these studies don't agree on a specific mechanism, they reveal that we have to consider the self-organization and interdependence of surface plate tectonics, mantle convection, and LLSVP evolution to understand the mechanisms leading to mantle plume lateral motions. So in this study, we actually investigated the dynamics of mantle plumes using an approach that allows to account for all these potential dependencies. And so to do so, So to do so, we used numerical models of whole mantle convection, such as this one, which was modeled using the STAG-YY code developed at Zurich. And here we used incompressible mantle convection by using the Businesque approximation, an earthlake Rayleigh number of 10 to the 7, a viscosity law of allowing 7 orders of lateral and radial viscosity variations throughout the domain, and a pseudoplastic rheology to allow the localization of surface deformation. And so these ingredients produce models with plate-like tectonics, with earth-like surface topography, heat flow, and plate velocity, as shown here on this movie, where here you can see, for example, a ridge. So in this very short presentation, I will actually focus on these three particular models. So one model is in stagnant lead with thermal plumes that you can see here. Another model here with plate tectonics plus thermal plumes. And this last model with plate tectonics and thermochemical plumes. And as you can see in red at the base of the mantle, here we have like the thermochemical piles that are stemmed by plumes. So we first made sure that all the models featured mantle plumes with earth-like characteristics by comparing the radius of the plumes, their temperature excess, their rising speed, their buoyancy flux, and their heat flux, so here in color for the models, with earth observations of plume characteristics, which are here in gray shaded areas on those plots. And then by tracking plumes through time, we actually found that both plate tectonics and basal thermochemical piles restrict plume lifetime, with only 10 to 50% of the plumes living longer than 100 million years in those models. We also tracked the vertical deflection of model plumes and found a limited effect of mantle wind on plume shape. And moreover, when comparing all these models, we found out that both plate tectonics and to an even greater extent basal thermochemical piles favor plume tilting. And then by extracting plume absolute and relative motion, we showed that both plate tectonics and basal thermochemical piles enhance plume mobility compared to stagnant lead. And however, so in all these cases, as you can see here with those numbers, plume motions stay reasonable, being less than a few centimeters per year on average in all cases. And we were also able to distinguish four causes for plume stability or mobility. So stable and slowly drifting plumes are actually controlled by the dynamics of the ambient Lauer-Most mantle flow. And interactions with slabs favor plume motions comprised between 1 centimeter per year and 5 centimeter per year, while the most rapid motions occur during plume conduit merging events, which happen every 100 million year on average in those models. So with this study, we showed that depending on the nature of their interactions with plate tectonics or with mantle convection, mantle plumes can actually behave differently, and that by choosing them carefully, we are still able to use some of them as an absolute reference frame. And with this last slide, I just wanted to stress that these models, although they have a free surface that doesn't reproduce plate reconstructions, they can help to create more geodynamically constrained plate reconstructions. And for example, we've been able, thanks to these models, to suggest that the Azores plume moved northward along the mid-Atlantic ridge over the past 85 million years at a speed of 1 to 2 centimeters per year. And we've also recently proposed a new plate reconstruction of the closure of the Neotethys ocean, which would involve the evolution of a subduction that you can see here that was induced by the Proto-Deccan plume. And this work is going to be out very soon. So with this last slide, I thank you for your attention, and I'm ready to take questions.